Hi, I'm Rich Crescenti, making a video tutorial here for Lessonface. I've been teaching audio for almost 10 years and I have over 10,000 hours experience in teaching. And today, we're going to be discussing how to navigate in Pro Tools. So I'm going to show you a few power tips that will make it easy for you to scroll, for you to navigate quickly and find any part of the audio that you need to. What I want to start off with is one of my favorites, which is the Tab button right here on the keyboard. Now, the Tab can work in two different ways, but generally what it will do is take your cursor and move it forward in the timeline, later in the timeline, along boundaries. Now, if you look right here on the screen, you'll notice there's a little button right here, a little blue button, and if you hover over it, it says Tab to Transients. If that button is on, or highlighted blue, when I move my cursor and hit Tab, let me zoom in here to show you this a little bit. When I zoom in right here, if you'll notice when I hit Tab, every time my cursor jumps to the next transient. If this button is off right here, and if I zoom out, you'll see, Tab will actually move us from clip boundary to clip boundary. So this is a great way if you have audio separated into multiple clips, Tab will go to the start of the next clip and to the start of the next clip. So two different ways to use Tab within Pro Tools allow you to move forward in the timeline. Easy. However, one of the Pro Tools power keys, and this is useful in many different ways, is the Option key right here. In movements like this in Pro Tools, Option, or Alt in Windows, in Pro Tools means the reverse. So you'll notice if I Tab, I move forward in the timeline. If I Option Tab, I move backwards in the timeline. So very useful. Tab moves you later in the timeline. Option Tab moves you earlier in the timeline. A very quick way to navigate through there. Some of my other favorite options to use with this are the Shift button. Shift means select in Pro Tools. So if I zoom in a little bit and go back to Tab to Transients, you'll notice that I can Tab to a drum hit and then Shift Tab to the next drum hit. This is a great way where if you capture a kick drum that is the perfect kick drum and you want to turn that into a sample, you can Tab to the front of that kick drum and Shift Tab to the next kick drum hit, and now you have exactly one hit selected right there. Great way to separate and make drum samples or isolate any one audio clip. Same thing holds true with our Option key right now. Shift Option Tab would select earlier into the timeline. Okay, now this moves us forwards and backwards in the timeline. Two keys that are connected to this are the Return key, right? Return brings you all the way to the beginning of the session, as we can see right there. And just as we talked about earlier, Option is the opposite. So Option Return moves your cursor all the way to the end of the session right there. So Tab to move forward, Option Tab to move back, Return moves you to the very beginning, Option Return moves you to the very end. This is perfect. Now we can quickly navigate forward and backward in time. But what about if you want to move your selection up or down? A very easy way to do that is with the letter P, which will move you up, and the semicolon, which will move you down. So let me give you another example right here. Let's say I want to come in and highlight one little clip of this drum set right here, right? I will Tab to the kick drum, Shift Tab to the next kick drum, so we get one kick drum hit. And if I want to move that entire selection down, the semicolon moves it down just like that. As you can see, it keeps that exact same selection in the timeline, but just moves it down through the screen. The letter P will move that upwards through the screen right there. Perfect. Easy ways to navigate in and around the time. That's way number one. Way number two that I want to talk about for navigating inside Pro Tools today is the universe view. Now, if you'll look up here at the top of the screen, I have this universe view right here. If you can't see that on your screen, you'll notice there is a little tiny arrow that points up on the right-hand side of the screen right there. If I click that, that universe view disappears. Now that arrow is pointing down. When I point down on it, we see our universe view right here. This is called the universe view because what it shows you at all times is the beginning of the session and the very end of the session as well. This highlighted gray box right here is what is currently being displayed on my screen. So you'll notice if I zoom out with the R key, that box gets bigger because now I've got a bigger portion of this session on screen. This is nice because you can zoom into a very small area and then click and drag this universe view around. A very, very easy way to see the entire session and quickly find, for example, right here at what's called our long transition where that starts. So that's the universe way. Way number two. Way number three that I want to discuss today is using markers inside Pro Tools. Now, to really maximize the usage of markers in Pro Tools, we'll need the standard 10 key, which is why I'm using this full-size keyboard here today, as opposed to the laptop keypad. This 10 key pad on the side of a full-size keyboard is incredibly useful for quickly navigating through markers. So I'm going to hit Option A, which zooms back out to the full size of the session in your timeline. And at the top, you'll notice that I have several markers right here. Verse 1, transition 1, verse 2, long transition, verse 3. I also have my window right here, memory locations, open up. Now you can click on this window to move from verse 1 to verse 2, and you can see the cursor moving, which whatever marker I choose right there. However, each marker has a number next to it. If you look in this little window, there's a little number next to that right there. Whenever you create a memory location, sometimes referred to as a marker in Pro Tools, it has a number that's associated with it. And to create a marker, you can either hit Enter on the numeric keypad, or you can hit this little plus button right next to the marker timeline right there. Great. Now once we've got these markers in place, it's very easy to navigate to. As you can see on this window, verse 1 is my first marker. So if I hit period 1 period on the numeric keypad, we jump right to verse 1. So I always lay all my markers in order at the beginning of a session, and then I know if I want to go to verse 1, period 1 period. If I want to go to verse 2, period 3 period. That is the third marker right there. Easy ways to jump around quickly within your timeline. Excellent. Another way to move around in Pro Tools, sometimes what we need is we need to move in minute amounts, and sometimes by exact minute amounts. So I'm going to introduce you to the feature called nudge inside Pro Tools. Nudge is very useful. I'm going to drop my cursor in on our drum set right up in here and zoom way in so we can really get up close and see what's going on. Now, if I drop my cursor right there, we've got the ability called nudge in Pro Tools, and nudge moves your cursor or a selection or an actual whole audio clip forwards or backwards by the amount set right here in the screen that says nudge. Now, if you click on the nudge, you can actually decide how much that is. Right now, bars and beats are selected, so within that menu, I can choose a nudge factor of 1 bar, a half note, a quarter note, eighth note, etc., based on musical timelines. If I come down here and choose minutes and seconds, my nudge is now based on absolute time. So I can nudge by 1 millisecond, 10 milliseconds, 1 whole second, whatever you decide is appropriate. Let's say I want to work within a musical frame and I want to nudge right here 1 quarter note. So wherever my cursor is, by dropping my cursor like that, I can now nudge the cursor forward or backward using the two left and right, the greater than or less than keys on our keyboard. You'll notice where my cursor is. If I hit the greater than key, that cursor nudges. That cursor nudges forward by 1 quarter note each time right there. If I hit this key pointing to the left, my cursor nudges by 1 quarter note. If I make a selection like so and nudge, then that nudge moves over by 1 quarter note. If I grab a clip of audio like so and I hit the nudge key, it moves that audio over by 1 quarter note every time. So, nudge key, very, very useful for moving things back and forth in the timeline by exact amounts. I also want to talk about our main counter up top right there. If you look at the top, we have our main counter in the timeline, which is where our cursor is. Right now, my cursor starts at bar 8, as you can see here on the screen. No matter where I drop my cursor, that will be demonstrated in this main counter right here. However, sometimes without using the mouse, you may want to jump to an exact spot. So, on the full-size keyboard, you'll notice there is an asterisk on this 10 keypad right here. By hitting asterisk on the 10 keypad, you'll notice we are highlighted right there at bar 13. So, all I have to do is type in bar 27 and hit enter, and my cursor will immediately jump to that timeline right there. This is great if you're working in a movie and you want to jump right to 1 hour, or if you're working within a song and you want to jump right to bar 32. However you want to move around, that main timeline is an easy way to do that. The last way that I want to go over today to navigate quickly within your timeline is the left and right arrows at the bottom of the screen, as well as the up and down arrows at the bottom of the screen. Now, this won't matter as much when you're zoomed out on the screen like we're looking at right now. However, if I zoom way in and press play, as this audio plays along, sometimes it is difficult to know where we are within the scene. So, if I stop it, I may not know where I am. The beauty of this is the left and right arrow will center your cursor in the center of the screen. So just by hitting the left arrow, wherever my cursor is, center of the screen. This comes in really beautiful if you want to quickly jump to the beginning or end of a clip. If I select this clip right here and hit the left arrow, the beginning of that clip jumps right to my center screen. If I hit the right arrow, the end of that clip jumps right to the center of the screen. This is great if you're zoomed in and want to keep the zoomed in view, but want to find the beginning of or end of that audio clip right there. Used in conjunction with the up and down arrows is a really useful way to drop your marker in at any moment and then find the beginning of that. Let me give you an example of that right here. If I play this song and decide I want to make a marker here, all you have to do is press the down key. Drop my cursor in right there, and then when I press stop, I don't know where my cursor is, but if I hit the left or right arrow key, right where I dropped that cursor in is now center of screen. So there you go. There are some very easy ways to navigate in and around Pro Tools that will make you a power user. I'm Rich Crescenti, and this is Lessonface. Thank you.